Welcome to this workshop. In this workshop, we will learn how to create blog from scratch in Gutenberg, okay? Today we have a mission. The mission is very important. If we don't get to create a Gutenberg blog from scratch today, we won't be able to dream tonight without nightmares. So we have to pay attention and create the blog correctly, okay? So, well, let's start. Okay, I am Pedro Crespo, developer of Mowomo, a company that makes custom plugins and themes for WordPress and WooCommerce. And well, my Twitter is PedroMCG95, and my website is Mowomo.com. This is a presentation. Okay, the preparative. So I now sit down and we will start to get in a lot of theory about Gutenberg blog. Testing. It's fine. It work? Yeah? No. Okay, I use both. Okay, I have to be so near here. Okay. Let's start. Okay, perfect. The first thing we have to install is Node.js, okay? We will need to have Node installed on our computer to be able to work with the Gutenberg blocks, okay? So this is the link, okay? We have to install three things. So I will give you time to install and download everything, okay? So don't care. While we are installing and downloading everything, I will be telling you a lot of theory about Gutenberg blocks. Okay, so don't care. The installing of everything takes more or less 7 minutes, so don't care. If you don't have installed Node.js, let's start. Okay.
What version of Node.js?
The latest version. You don't need the latest version, but you can go to the page and it's the same. Okay. We need a WordPress installation where we will be able to test our blog. Okay. So I personally use LocalWP. It's a very great tool. Okay. We can have a lot of WordPress different WordPress versions installed in our PC. We can test our plugins in different versions, so it's okay. You can go to this link, okay, and download. Here, okay. And after this, we will use the package of Node WordPress / create blog. Okay, this tool is official of WordPress. And this tool, you can use it to create Gutenberg blocks from scratch. Okay? If you install this package and use it, you will get a block of a text perfectly done with a lot of comments. So you will be able to learn with this blog and read a lot of documentation. Okay, but I will explain you every important file inside of the plugin. Okay. And I will explain you too the functionality of all, okay? So let's start with the installation of the WordPress, okay, to give you time. I have here the local WP installed, okay? I press this button, add a local site, create a new site. For example, for Camiuro. Camiuro, 2023, okay. We have to click in Advanced Options. Everything okay? Okay, I have another, so two, for example, or workshop. Okay. Let's continue. We have to click in custom, okay. Set the correct version of PHP. We have to try to at least take the most advanced version of PHP, for example, the 8.1.9. The web server, this tool usually install the engines, okay? But I prefer always Apache. And the database, use MySQL 8.0.16, okay? Let's continue. Create the most advanced security user and password. Admin, obviously. Your email, okay? And this will take no more than 1 minute, I think, okay? This will be very fast. If it's your first time creating a new local site, maybe you have to give permissions to install, okay, like me, for example. It's not my first time, but he asked me for permissions, okay? Okay, we are downloading WordPress. Okay, let's see if the internet connection is well here. I think that yes. Okay. After this, we will open the folder WP content and go to the folder plugins. And we will write the command line of the it's like before. Okay. We will have to create to write this command line, okay? With Node installed. Okay. What? Inside of the plugins folder, okay. So you have installed, or if you have one installation of WordPress already, so you can write the command, okay? Because this command have more or less need 7 or 8 minutes to create the plugin, okay? So start if you can. Okay.
Same. It will take a lot more in this network.
Okay.
Wi-Fi is really slow.
Yes. Well, we will have time to do it. Okay.
Then try to do it better on the phone.
I have now the WordPress installed correctly. Okay. In this tool, we can set this option: one-click admin to on. And select the admin to always log in as an admin. Same. What?
The query behind the screen.
Yes. Ah, okay, perfect. This command? Okay. Yes. Well, I will go to there now, so don't care. I will go to this link, okay, to the go to site folder. In the local tool, this button will open the installation of the local of our WordPress site. We go to app, public, WP content, plugins, and inside of this, we have to open the terminal and press and write the next command. I can copy and paste, but I will give you the time here, okay? nps.wordpress/create blog, my first blog, for example. Okay. 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 Well, let's start this because it takes more or less 7 or 8 minutes, okay? If I can't install this, I have another installation with the tool installed, so don't care, say.
Can we use Vue or LI?
Can you repeat that, please?
You have two options.
Okay.
After running it, it gives me an option of getting a framework.
Okay.
Vue or LI? React
is
canceled out, so I'm just asking which one.
Okay, you only have to say yes. Okay, because now this tool hasn't asking me, okay? But after this installed, you just have to, I will say later, okay? We have to wait a bit, that more or less the most of the people have installed the tool, okay? Okay. So this tool is very, it's very important because it's official by WordPress, okay? And I began with the WordPress blogs of Gutenberg in 2089, I think, and I had to create a tool for this, and was incredible. Was incredible. Was very hard to begin to create Gutenberg blogs, but with this tool, we have easier to create blogs from scratch, so I am very happy with this tool, okay? Okay. How many of you have the at least one WordPress installed in your PC? Okay, perfect. And how many of you have this is running this command line? Okay, a lot of you will have nightmares this night. We have to accomplish the mission, okay? Okay, so installing WordPress scripts. This takes a lot of time because this tool needs a lot of node modules to work correctly, okay? It needs a lot. If you try to move the folder, okay, of this tool to another folder, it will take a lot of time because there are a lot of small files there. So try to type the command line in the correct folder that is in plugins, okay? Okay, with this line formatting JavaScript files, okay, we are finishing, okay. Now we have a lot of console commands, okay? The most important console command is the npm start, okay? With this command, we will say to the tool that we are programming Gutenberg blocks, and the tool will be compiling, okay? Every time that we save a file into the source folder that I will show now, and we'll export the information to a build folder, okay? That I will show you now, okay? And the npm run build. This is to get a folder completely compiled, compressed in point zip and installed in a Gutenberg, in a WordPress installation, okay? So now that we have the plugin, the tool created, okay, and the plugin installed too, we can go to this button, WP admin, and we will now see our first block, okay? I can move a lot. Okay, if we go to plugins, this is very important because some of you maybe think, oh my God, the tool is not working correctly because I don't see the block in the editor. No, you haven't enabled the plugin, okay, in the plugin link. This is so simple. Activate the plugin, okay. We have the plugin here inside. Go now, for example, to pages. Add a new page. Name it, for example, blocks. And if we type here slash my first blog, we will have here now our first blog, okay? It's a very simple blog, but have all the structure that we will need to create edit the blog, okay? So publish, and I recommend you to have to open this page in another tab, okay? So we will have these two tabs always open, okay? This is the editor side of the blog, say the editor, the Gutenberg editor, okay? This is the editor side, and this is the front-end side, okay? This is very important because in the creation of Gutenberg blogs, we have two sides. The backend, the editor, okay? That is this. And the front-end side, okay? How many of you have installed the plugin at currently? Okay. You will sleep tonight well. Okay. Perfect. Okay, more internet connection for the rest of the people. Okay, we can close that. We can close this. I will open my ID. New window. And for example, I have to go to the folder of the plugin, inside of the plugin. Okay, we will have here a lot of files and folders. I copy the path. Go to open folder. Okay, select the folder. And now we are in Visual Studio Code with the plugin opening, okay? Okay, we have a lot of time, okay. Now we can open the command line, okay? The console, here inside of the ID or inside the folder, okay? You can select, if you are in Windows, open the terminal and do the same, okay? I will do it in the console, okay, here. And we have to type npm start. And if everything is correct, we will see these lines, okay? And now I have to tell you something. If you don't see nothing red here, everything is well. And close the tab, okay? If you see that you are programming the blog and you can't, you stop to see change in your blog, there is something red in this console, okay? So you will have to come to here, okay? So we minimize the tab, okay? And let's start to explain all the theory. Meanwhile, the rest of the people is installing the tool, okay? Preparations, we have now the blog, okay. Anatomy of a blog plugin, okay? Opening the folder, we will see these folders, okay, and these files. The build folder is very important because contains all our blog compile and prepare to use in WordPress, okay? We won't have to code anything here. We won't have to touch anything here. So if we touch something here, possibly the blog will break. So don't touch this, okay? The node modules, the same. You don't have to open this, ni see this, ni touch this for nothing, okay? If you touch something here, possibly you will have nightmare, okay? So care about this. Yeah, okay. The source folder, okay. You will be here the most of the time, okay? The most of the time, so don't care. This is possibly the only folder that you have to open inside of this plugin, okay? We will go inside of the folder after, okay? My first blog. Okay. This is the typical PHP file that tell to WordPress that this folder is a plugin with their headers and all, and we will have here more information. Okay, I don't know. Okay, do you see where the code? Yes, no? Okay, thank you. Here we have all the definitions of the plugin, all the headers, okay? I don't have to tell us. This is the plugin name, description, okay? This is the typical thing in a plugin, okay? And we will have here the register block type. With this function, we will be telling to WordPress that we are creating a blog, and WordPress can search all the files inside the build folder. Okay? So really WordPress is seeing all the time inside of the build folder, not in the source folder. Okay? Okay. Let's see with the readme.txt. This plugin is important to if you want to upload to the repository of WordPress the plugin, okay, and tell to the repository of WordPress all the information about the blog, but I don't enter in this, okay? Anatomy of a blog. The blog JSON, okay? Here we have all the source folder opening, okay? The blog JSON, in this file, we will configure everything about our blog, okay? Let's explain something. I say you, more or less 10 minutes of theory, and after this, we will be programming all the time, so don't care. The API version, in this line, we are saying to WordPress which API version of Gutenberg, right, and are we using, okay? Current version is 2. Name, the name of the look of the plugin, okay? You have to create here a string, slugified, okay? The title of the blog is here, in the title, okay? You can write my first blog, my second blog, my end blog, okay? The category, this is very important, okay? If we go to here, and click in this button and go to what was the category?
Widgets.
Okay, thank you. You are paying attention, okay? Widgets. So here will we see my first blog. Okay, so we have learned now that in this line, in the category line, we will be able to configure what is the category of the blog, okay? The icon, you put the icon that you want, okay? A smile, we always have to be smile. Description, so the description, okay? Support, this is very important. I won't tell you nothing now, okay? But programming, we will be seeing here a lot of cool things. This is very, very cool to play with Gutenberg blocks, okay? You will be surprised with this. So this is incredible, okay? The test domain to internationalize the lines of the blog, okay? It's very important to don't write only the blog in your language. You have to let other people to translate the blog into other languages, okay? The editor script, the location of the script in the build folder, the editor style, the location of the editor style in the build folder, the style, okay, and just all. I have to go to here, the index.js. This is like if the blog.json is the metadata of the plugin, okay, if the information, the headers, no, like the headers of a plugin, so is the information of a blog, okay? In the index.js, you will program the, you will connect the edit view with the save view, okay? We will connect we will connect this part, this code, the code from here, with this code, okay? The front end and the editor side. Okay. We will have the register block type, okay? Use it to, to register the new block. It's the most important possibly function here, okay? In this function, we see here that we insert the name of the plugin, okay, the Slack. We connect the edit and the save. After, if we have time, we will configure a bit these lines, okay, to make the block more or less dynamic, okay, and render the block in the front end with PHP instead of with JavaScript, okay, but later. Metadata, let's go with the edit.js, okay, that is here. It's the file where we will be programming the edit side of the block, okay? Let's explain a bit. These two underlines, okay, are for translating every string of the block, okay? The use block props, okay? This is to give to WordPress the ability to show into the container of the inside of the container of the folder of the plugin, okay? All the classes or the every class, every style from the support, from everything, okay? So this is very important. We will use there, okay? In the first tag of the code, okay? We connect the editor CSS and export the file function edit. With this function, we will export to the index.js the code from the editor side, okay? And the same to the save.js. With this file, we will be programming the front-end side of the block, okay? This will be changed after, okay, if we have time, for the render PHP, okay? To render the block with PHP instead of with JavaScript, okay? We use to the use block props and the export the file function save, okay? It's very important because we have to have here the same display code, okay? The same functionalities, okay? That here, that in the edit side, okay? And after this slide, I will close the PowerPoint. And like this slide said, let's code in. Okay. We will start to code here, okay? Wait a second. We have a lot of code to program here, so, okay. I don't want to remember nothing, so this is important, okay? Do you see where the... Okay, I think that you will see now the code well, okay? You see the code well? Yeah. See code well? Okay, thank you. You are paying attention. Okay, this is the block JSON. Ah, here we have the API version 3. Okay. Okay, perfect. I expect that anything changed from the version 2. Oh my God. Okay, perfect. Okay. Go to this file. For example, we are beginning to change something, okay? That to see that this is running, okay? Go to this console, see everything green and nothing red. Okay, it's correct. So go to the edit.js, for example, and change this text, okay? It's simple. We possibly can change to hello from the WordCamp Euro 2023. If we save this, okay, and we go to this console, this has changed, but we don't see it, okay? Everything is hitting, okay, so no problems. We have to remove the block. This is a bit bored, but well, reload the page and re-put the block inside the editor, okay? And save, update the page, and reload the, okay, we are seeing now things, okay? Ah, yes, why is this? Because we have changed the text in the edit file, but not in the front-end side, so we have to go here. At this time, the console, the command lines don't have errors, okay? But there is here something that will throw the errors. If you right click in the mouse, okay, and click in inspection, you will see here the console. Very perfect. Okay, this usually don't let you save the content, okay, if the content here is different from here. And show you a big red error, so now no, okay, don't care. I wanted to show the error, but well. Okay, we copy the line. And now we will see the same text, okay? Yes, okay. Everything is well, okay. Now we have the problem because the save side of the front end side of the block have changed, so the block breaks. So for this, we have to remove every time the block and reinsert it, okay? Update. And we have now the front end side of the block changed, okay? Perfect. Let's begin inserting some values, okay? To begin to configure something, okay? For example, we will learn now how to insert variables here, okay? The variables here have the names of attributes, okay? What are the attributes? Okay, are the variables inside of the block that we can use to store information of specific of the block and connect the information between the save and the edit version of the block, okay? For example, we are going to insert now attributes, okay? Okay, possibly text, no? Text, I have the GitHub Copilot, but only for autocomplete, don't care for that. Okay, it's very useful because it's reading all the node modules, so I don't lose any line or any import, so perfect. Text. We have to configure here the type of the variable. For example, if we want to save a string, we have to say that we want the type a string, okay? If we want, for example, to save a Boolean is a yes or no variable, we can type Boolean, okay? And this will store a yes or a no, okay? We will start with a text, okay? Text, we can put here. String. Yes, the string, correctly. You are paying attention. A string, okay, perfect. The file, for example, we will use here, hello, welcome. Europe 2023, okay. Save the block JSON, okay. Now, possibly, we have errors in the console. Okay, everything okay. If I, for example, commit an error and save, we will see this red. Okay, it's in red, but normally it's red, okay? But this has a stop, okay? And everything you do after this error won't be changed in the build file, in the build folder. So if you are programming, chilling very well, okay, and you don't see any change in the block, it's because you have a problem in your console, okay? So check this, npm start. Okay, okay, we have the same problem because I haven't changed it. Okay. Reload the tool, npm start. Okay, everything's successful. So we can now go to our blog and we won't see anything because we have to program the attributes, okay? For example, we are going to change this text for an input where we can input text, okay? So we are going to introduce the, for me, the most important component here, that is the rich text, okay? This is very useful, okay? You can do a lot of things with this. Meanwhile, you are programming the blog, you will have to insert components and other dependencies in the block, okay? So for example, if we want to use a rich text, we have to insert in the import WordPress block editor, okay? The string rich text, okay? With this, we will be able to use the rich text, okay? It's so easy. We just have to insert rich text here, and after this, we will be able to use this. Okay. I have learned something in these days, very useful. I didn't know that this tag, but it's this. Okay. This tag is nothing, but it's all. So, after this, you will see why it is very important, this tag, okay? It's nothing, but it's all, remember this. Okay, let's insert the rich text, okay? Rich text. We have now the rich text. We have to, I wish it down, this. Okay. The tag name. With this attribute for the component, we'll be saying to the block, to the component, which tag we have to we want to use. Okay, if we have a H2, H3, H1, a paragraph, an span, okay, we can select here. Okay, tag for example P, and we put for example tag name value. Okay. With the value attribute, we need here to introduce, to insert the attributes, okay? Attribute and set attribute, okay? we need to insert this into the block to use it. If we don't insert attributes and set attributes in the params of the function, we won't be able to use it, okay? Okay. Perfect. Attributes, for example, the value of attributes. We have the attribute text, okay. Let's put text here, okay? And we have to set the what happens if the input changes, okay? How we do this? Saying what... what is doing here, okay? On change, we have to open curly brackets, then We have to write here the variable, okay? And set attributes. This function is to save one value into one variable, okay? Into one attribute. For example, text. Okay. With this, we have now an input in the editor side to change the text, okay? And not have only the what we have here, my first flow, hello, blah, 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 okay? We have to use this. Okay, and we need now to insert in the save point JS the same component, okay? Reach text to receive the information stored in the attribute text, okay? We import in this line, in the block editor components, okay? The reach text. We set here, okay, the attributes. We don't need here the set attribute because this is for the front end. We won't save anything here, okay? So only the attributes, okay, and change this for reach text. Point content, okay? With this version of the write state, we will get the store value, okay, of the attribute, okay? Formatted with the tag that we want, okay? For example, I close this and put here tag name. We have here the P, no? So put here P. Okay, and set the value to attributes point text. Okay. So we have now a rich text point content that will show the value stored in attributes point text. Okay. As a paragraph, okay? The value on chain, we don't have to write the on chain here because we won't save anything in this side, okay? We will only show information in this side, okay? Return value, we see the console, everything is okay. If we remove the block, save, reload, and put my first block. We will see now the Hello WordCamp Europe 2023. Okay, and you will ask why before do this the background color of the editor of the block was blue and now not. Okay, it's because I have forgotten something very important. That is the use block props. Okay. We have to use the block props here. Okay, use block props. Three points. Oh, here no. Okay. And inside here, yes. Oh my. Okay.
Can you edit for?
Okay. I don't know how. Why this is now failing? Okay. Wait a moment, please.
You have to wrap it in the brackets.
The brackets, okay. Okay. Ah, okay, perfect. Sorry. The nervous. Okay. Okay. Perfect here and now, okay, perfect. Okay, perfect, now yes. Oh my God, the curly brackets. Deep, okay, and now we have to write here a deep. The rich text content, and use the same, use block props. Here is, save. Okay, we have to use here in the save version of the file, a different version of use block props, okay? We now have the use block props and the parentheses, and now we have the point save parentheses, okay? And if we check the console, everything is okay.
Can you show the editor, Chase?
Okay. The editor here?
The editor,
okay. This. We have the div with the curly brackets. Thank you. The 3 points, the use block props, parentheses. Okay. 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 And in the save version, we have to use 3 points, use block props, point save, and parentheses. Okay, on change, you have to open brackets, parentheses, text, equal, and plus done, set attributes, parentheses, curly brackets, and text, okay? Okay. We don't need this. Okay. Okay. If we, for example, remove the block, save and reload. We will have now the styles that we had before, okay? Because now we will see here if we save, update, if we inspect this, we'll see now, okay, these classes and this information, okay? We will see WP block, create block, my first block, okay? That is is basically the look of the block, okay? And we will have all the classes from here, okay? Okay, let's change something. For example, hello world. We can change the text for whatever we want. And we will see the change, okay? So now we have a rich text, okay, an input to change the text, okay, inside of the block. Up your hands who have the block at this point. Okay. Well, we have to try it. Okay. Let's introduce more complex to the block, okay? For example, if here something like a H2 and H2. And for example, we are going to be faster now. We are going to insert information in this sidebar, okay? This sidebar is the inspector sidebar, okay? We can use the setting sidebar with the following imports, okay? We need to go to the, I will close this a bit. we will have to go to the block editor and introduce the inspector controls, okay? Inspector controls. With this, we will be able to configure an a sidebar settings bar, okay? Inspector controls. Okay. And we have to insert now new imports that will be import, okay, panel body. This is like a table, okay, with the tbody, tfooter, with the TDs, tRows, okay, it's more or less the same. So we will need the panel body, the panel row for the rows of the setting sidebar, okay? And for example, a toggle control, okay? Toggle control and from WordPress/components, okay? We have to use the components, okay? I'm seeing your faces, typing code, okay? Panel body, panel row, and toggle control, okay? Because we are going to insert in the sidebar a toggle control that we will control if we have, for example, an H2, okay, or a paragraph. So we are going to introduce some of conditional logic inside of the block, okay? Conditional logic is, for example, we are going to create a new attribute, name block with header, okay? Instead of with paragraph. If we set the variable to the attribute to header, we will have a header, and if we set the variable to attribute, we will have an attribute. We will have a paragraph, okay? So we have to go to the block JSON, go to here, insert a new attribute, for example, with header. We put the type of Boolean and set the default to true. Okay. I use the uppercase in the T. Okay, maybe this has changed. No, this is correct. Okay. We have the new attribute in the block point JSON. Name with header, type Boolean, and default true. Okay. We can now go to the same. Okay, what do you want to see? The block JSON, the edit. Okay, the block JSON. We have this new attribute with header. Type Boolean and default true. Okay. You will have good dreams tonight. Okay, with header. We go now to the edit point JS, and we will configure the inspector controls, okay? This is a part of the side, of the front-end side, okay? In the front-end side, we won't have to introduce the inspector controls, okay? We will only have to write the inspector controls in the edit JS. Okay, now we have to set the panel body, and we will set a title. Okay, for example, basic configuration. Basic configuration. In this function, okay, with the two underlines, we have to set first the text, the string, okay? And after the string, the text domain of the plugin, okay? If we set the text domain to my first block, we will have to copy this text domain and go to the edit.js, edit.js, and introduce my first block, okay?
Sorry.
Rich text, not find it. Okay, that is because possibly you have to see this code. Okay, we have here the use block props, the rich text, and the inspector controls. So check that you have correct these lines. Okay, save, and we will have to get the rich text correctly. Okay. We have to close here the panel body with this panel body with the close tag, okay? And we will have to put now, you are following having the error of the restate? No? Oh, okay, perfect. We can now introduce all the panel rows that we want, okay? This is like a small bot inside of the sidebar configuration, okay? We will see now. Panel row. Okay, and for example, we can put now the toggle control. Okay. No. We want this. We want this version of the toggle control. We will put a label, okay, to show the text, the small text, near to the input, okay? For example, show a header. Show a header. The value, okay? Okay. Here we don't have to use the value, we have to use the check it attribute, okay? Check it, curly brackets, and use the attribute that we have created some minutes before, okay? Attributes show header. What? With header, okay, perfect. With header, okay. You are paying a lot of attention. Okay, and the typical function for what happens if we change the input, okay? So, on chain, curly brackets, the variable. This with header, this is not the variable inside of the attribute, okay? This is a temporary variable that contains that store the information of the SchengenGit input, okay? And we have to use the equal plus than set attributes parentheses curly bracket with header, okay? If we save this, I will toggle control. Perfect, thank you. toggle control, we have the label, we have the check it, and we have the on-chain attributes, okay? We don't need more here. I will let this screen here a bit more. Okay, and now in the front-end side, we are not going to write nothing of this, okay? We will use now the conditional logic, okay? Change the tag name of the rich text depending of the value of the with header attribute, okay? I will go down And I will put here the curly brackets, okay? And we'll put if attributes with header, we put the interrogant icon, okay? And if the attributes point with header is true, we'll show H2, okay? And if it's false, we'll show a P. And how can we connect this with the front side? So easy. We go here and put the same code. Copy and paste. I will let the screen here, okay? With the curly brackets, attributes point with header, interrogant, okay? And H2, 2 points, P, okay? And copy, oh my God, copy and paste the same here, okay? Okay, let's check if everything is correct here, okay? We are going to remove the block, okay, my first block. I will put again the screen, okay, don't care. And we will now see the header here, okay? And if we, for example, in the basic configuration, set the show a header to false, we will see the P, okay, the paragraph. Sample update the block, and we will see the block correctly running, okay? I will put again the code. Do you need the save or the edit side? Ah, okay. The restate. Okay. Save.
So, on line 47, you have unchanged with header, okay?
Okay.
What if I add another toggle control? How does it know which one to use?
Change at the same time.
Let's say I add another toggle control that says show me the money or something.
I think that change.
How does the edit know which with header to use?
I think that both. We will see it now, okay? Because the set attributes, when you set one attribute, okay?
Yeah.
Say is set for all the block, okay?
Okay.
So for that we could use the conditional here, okay?
Okay. Do you have the with header in the block JSON?
Okay. Yes, in the block JSON here with header.
Ah. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So I have to use another one.
And I have
something different.
That body. Okay.
That is the part that was the question.
Okay. So now I reload the game.
New attribute.
No, I have to remove. Save and reload. This is very important. My first block and both change at the same time. Okay?
Yeah, but my question was if it was a different
a different toggle?
A different toggle, but I see toggle? That in the block JSON you declared it.
Okay.
With header.
Okay.
That's why I was confused.
Ah, okay, okay. Perfect, perfect.
Okay.
So, well, I will remove this toggle control. Okay, reload. We are going to see now the supports of the blocks. This is very awesome, okay? You won't need to code nothing, basically, to get a lot of features, okay? So, for example, we are going to the block.json and go to here, okay? And for example, I want to be able to change the color of the block, okay? My first block, and I want to have here, in this sidebar, another column with the styles of the block, okay? So we can go to here, to the handbook, okay, of WordPress. WordPress handbook, Gutenberg blog. Here there are a lot of information about Gutenberg blog, okay? And we are going to see all the supports, okay? How to guides. I think that here, okay, in the handbook, okay, how to guides, blogs, and blog supports, okay? If you go to blog supports, you will see a lot of awesome features. This is incredible. We will see, okay? For example, control blog supports, the support documentation, it's here. Okay, if we control F, oh my God, the color, okay, we have the support for a color, and we will have attributes that we don't have right here in this attribute, but we will have new attributes by the support, okay? If we put, for example, here, color, and we put, for example, text, okay, oh my God, this bots, text, true, okay, text true, and background true. We will have now the ability, this has stopped, no, okay, this is everything well. If we now remove the block, save, reload, this is always the same, okay? We will have now the my first block. Okay, here is happening something. We are going to close this. Yes. Okay. Support. Okay. The supports. And okay, it's everything okay. I was seeing here, but it's in this side, okay? Sorry. In the register sidebar, we will see now these two buttons, okay? The column of the configuration that we have set before, and now this button to set the color of the block. For example, we can set the color to black, for example, so easily. And point, for example, to something that is can be good, okay? For example, this. Okay, we can read this. Well, if we update the block, we now will have the block with the possibility to control the color easily. We just have to code 4 lines, okay? Color, text, and background. And I think that we can use to the anchor for the links, but we don't have links now. Color, background. Okay, I don't see it now here, but anchor, okay, perfect. So for example, another good support that we can use is the alignment, okay? The align, okay. Oh my God, here. Okay, if we put here, we write here the support. We have to remove this. The support here, align. And set true this value, okay? Now we will be able to, everything is okay, okay. Remove the block, reload. we will be able to align the block to wherever we want, okay? We have now, if you have problems selecting the container of the block, you can go to this button and click this, okay? And you will see now this control, the align control. And we can set now if we want the block aligned to the left, aligned to the right, aligned to the center, full width, okay? Middle width, so easily with a line of code, okay? If we write in supports the align value and set to true, we have this automatically. This is awesome. I say you, this is incredible, okay? And if we save, we have now a full width block, okay? If we inspect this block, we will see now here more information, okay? Okay. With the styles of the align full, okay? Here is the class. That's all. Okay. And the color, for example, to yellow, no. Color of the text to black and color of the background to yellow. If we save now, we will see more information here. Okay, we will see now the a lot of more classes, okay? Okay, let's see, for example, another useful support that is the spacing.
Sorry, how do you, is there a way of defining the colors?
Another colors?
Yeah.
With this support, no, because this is only for these colors, okay? Like general colors, okay? Text, background, and I know that.
But where does it take the color palette? So where does it take these colors?
If you have, for example, what are you asking?
So the colors that you have in the editor, where does it take it from?
Okay, from attributes that take the from attributes that don't have the block JSON here. But WordPress understand that if you write here the support color, okay, and you set text and background to true, you have now attributes here, okay, for that information, but you don't have to write that attribute, okay? Are as a general common attribute, okay? So that information is there, okay? If you want to configure the value of the color, to get the color, okay. I think
so
that.
I've heard the answer that it's probably coming from the thing.
Yes, yes. Support.
Yeah. Unless you override.
I think that. I don't know exactly because I only use the support with that and let the. To WordPress put the class of the color, so I didn't mind that. So. I will check now if we can see. I think that no, but well. How was the name? Okay, background color. Maybe we can test it, okay? We don't have fails here, okay. Okay, the color is there in that attributes, okay? You can go to the handbook, see what attributes are here, okay? And for example, the background color, the style, okay? You can come to the documentation and see all the attributes, okay? And use them. Attributes, text, okay? We are at the same point. For example, we are going to introduce now a new text here. For example, upper text, and we will show you I will show you now more conditional logic, okay? To more to show information if exists, okay? Example, we can make a new panel row. And put, for example, the text control. The text control is a control, like the rich text is a simple text input, okay? You can insert in the input the simple text and just all, okay? You can't set the tag of the input, only the value, okay? Text control, for that you need to insert here in the components, okay? The text control, okay, and save. And we have I give you a time, okay? Text control in the WordPress components, okay? WordPress components import line, text control, okay? Okay, and if we go to the panel row, text control, and set the typical label, okay? If for example, description, no? A description for the blog, okay? Description, value, okay? We need a new attribute. For example, we will name it as description, no? Description. I don't want to see more that red color, okay? So text control, we need to configure later the on-chain, okay? The on-chain attribute. But first we are going to write a new attribute here. For example, okay, I will put this attribute after them. Description will be an attribute of type, oh my god, this alert, of type string, and by default we'll have the text of this is a description, okay? If we save the default, the attribute, we check the command lines, okay, everything is well. We go to the edit.js, we set now the on-chain function. Okay, to the block JSON? Okay. Okay, perfect. Okay. The description. Description, type string, default, whatever you want. If you want to write a new description, you can. I want to show you the PHP render, but I think I won't be able to do it. Okay, the description, okay, type default.
Could you show edit.js?
Okay, the edit.js. Do you need the import?
Okay, yes, that was wrong.
In the import, we have to set text control in the component side, okay? Component side, I will show you bigger the information. Import, we have the panel body, panel row, text control, and toggle control. Okay.
What you write on the text on the wall panel, in the text control?
Okay, I will show you now that. In the code, okay, we have now the text control here inside a panel row. Okay, we are inside of the inspector controls, okay? It's panel row, text control, level, label, value, on chain, and we will write here. Description is always the same function, okay, to save the information. Other people create a function outside of this, but I think that this is more clean, okay? This is cleaner. It's a very small string, so we can have this line here, no? Description, arrow, set attributes, parentheses, curly bracket, description. Okay. Text control with the label, the value, and the on change. The on change with description, arrow, set attributes. Okay, to description. Okay. Okay. And let's put that information, okay, in the under the read state, for example. Because it's a description, so it's the typical position of of a description under a header, okay? But we are going to write the conditional logic, okay? It's very simple. We have to write curly brackets. Okay, I will stop a bit. Text control. Do you need something of some file? What? Okay, I don't have error now. Okay, the console of the node modules. Okay, restart the npm start. Okay, check if. Hey, what? Ah, yes, Laravel components, no? Yes. Laravel, okay, perfect. Yes, it's similar. Yeah. You have the same structure as a Laravel, yes? Another framework, you have the components, the attributes, save it. Okay. We are going to see now, okay? I will follow with the conditional logic. Okay. We will see if attributes description exists, okay? It has content and that. Put interrogant and this is very important, okay? You have to press to write parentheses. Open and close of parentheses. And after that, point double points and null. Okay? With this, we have now the conditional logic because I will open this and put inside information, okay? If we write a lot of information inside of this parentheses, but after this, we forget to write the double point null, we will have here a problem, okay? So, for example, We can write now API. Okay, we don't have errors now, okay? I will show you, I will let the screen here, okay, to show this information. Curly brackets, attributes, point description, interrogant, parentheses, parentheses, double point, null, okay? And inside of the paragraph, we will open curly brackets, we'll call the attributes point description. Okay. Well, the parentheses has gone off because it's only one line, okay? But I used to write the parentheses, okay? So, well. What? In what line? In the block JSON? In the description, type string. Okay. Okay, okay, perfect, perfect. So now we are going to connect this this attribute to the save JS. Okay, we have to do the same. Okay, we can copy and paste. Usually we will be able to copy and paste the lines. Okay, from the edit JS to the save JS. Okay, we have now a half an hour, so I will introduce you to the dynamic block, okay, with the PHP, that it's easier than this. Okay. And I think that is very useful, okay? Attributes, you have to copy from edit.js and save, okay? The console is okay. We have remember to remove, save, reload the editor, my first block, and like we config the attribute description with a default, and this default have content in the edit.js, this check that the attribute have content, so we'll show will display the paragraph, okay? So here we have the paragraph. And if we remove the content of the paragraph, of the description, the block will hide the paragraph, okay? For example, this is a description, okay? And if we save the block, and go to the front-end side, we will get the same information, okay? Okay. Did you get the description with the conditional? No, okay. This is not easy. I will try to go slower. Okay. Okay, okay, perfect. But this is, you can understand better this line. It's more understandable, okay?
Yeah.
For the workshop.
Yes, right.
But sorry, thank you. No, don't care. So if I write this, I can say if something happened, interrogant, everything is okay, so we go to this part, and after, if nothing happens here, because this is empty, so we go to null. That is nothing, okay? We don't display anything, okay? Reset. Okay, I have to advance a little bit to show you the PHP. That will be easier, okay? Okay. Okay, if we go, well, no, the PHP, well, okay. If we go to here, okay. If we go to, yes, more or less, if you remove this, if you remove the inspector control, more or less it's the same. But the difference here are the use block props point save and the restate point content. And you don't have here the on-chain functions, okay? Okay. And remember to import the restate component, okay, in the import. Okay, in this line, my line is the seventh line. Okay. Control C. Okay. The save? Okay, this. Okay, perfect. Okay. Okay, perfect. So we are go now to the block JSON, block point JSON. At the end of the JSON, okay, we are going to set a new attribute, name double quotes render. Okay, and write file double point point slash render point PHP. And this is magic. Okay. This is easier. Okay. This is a line. But we have new to we have now to create now a field inside the source folder name render PHP. Okay? Inside the source folder, a new file name render.php. Okay. And we need other thing, okay? That is to go to the index.js and kill save. Save double point null. But we have to insert here the attributes to at least use the attributes, okay? So the block JSON is with the line render. I go now to the index.js, okay, this line. Save double point parentheses attributes right arrow null. Okay. Okay, we need the block JSON attribute render, okay, pointing to the file render PHP. We need the I will close the save yes now. index.js, okay, with this line like this. And a new file in the source folder src name render PHP. Okay.
How can I use the attributes that is not parameterized?
What? I
released a block type. There is no parameterized names, attributes. How can I use it inside the same?
Okay, I will show you now, okay, how we can use the attribute, okay, in the render PHP. In the render point PHP, we will have now the attribute because we pass by parameters the attributes here, okay?
But that attribute is undefined in the file, right? It's not passed.
Okay, perfect. Attribute, okay. No. I have forgotten the curly brackets. No, it's okay. The attributes. Oh, I think it's okay. Okay, let's check, okay. Everything is well. We will have here the attributes, okay. So go to the block.json and we have the text, the width header, and the description. So go to the render PHP and write text that will be text equal to attribute. Well, no, we have to open the PHP line, okay? Write less than interrogant PHP, okay? And after this, write the attributes, okay? Tests, attributes, we will have the variable attributes here, okay? And it's an array, okay? We can get all the information or the attributes because it's an array here, okay? And write text, for example. I am going to copy and paste 3 times for the 3 attributes, okay? I am going to let you time now. I am going to write and let the attributes with header. Okay. And description. So you can copy from here. And we will have now the information, okay? And now we have to show the same information that the edit.js or the save.js, okay? So we have here a div, okay? We close the PHP. I will write the tags, okay? Simple. H2 text and paragraph more text, okay? More or less, this is the same structure of the save.js, but we have to write more information here, okay? Give the conditional give the dynamic logic to the blog, okay? Here, we need the function, use block props, okay, but with PHP. What function it does? This function, okay? We open here PHP, and the function is get echo, get block, wrapper, attribute, okay? And with this function, we will get the same return than with the use block props point save, okay? I put the render PHP. Okay. Okay. I will now write here the information of the H2, okay? I have to put a logical condition. We open and close PHP. We write if, the typical if, okay? And check if we have header. if we have header, we can show. I usually write the full structure of the if, okay? So later I don't forgot that, okay? And if this is the structure, okay? Okay, I need more time. Okay, with header, else, and an if, okay? If we have the with header, we write heading 2, okay? Open PHP, close PHP, and echo with header. And if we don't have the with header, we write a paragraph, open PHP, close PHP, echo description. Okay, with header come from here, and echo. Yes, this is a boolean. Ah, no, omega, sorry. Yes, was an error. I write here the with header, okay? Sorry.
That should be the text.
Description, omega. The text, perfect, thank you. Okay, we have here the with header, the text, and the text, okay? And now, we can put here the copy and paste the conditional logic, but we don't need the else here. P paragraph, and now yes, description. And this will be description two, okay? We check here if we have a content in the description value, variable, and if have information, we'll show the description text, okay? So if everything is well, we will see now in the build, okay, everything is well, the render PHP file, because it's running the webpack, okay, the console, and we'll introduce the render PHP in the build folder, okay? So I will give you more time. Well, I have to check this. I think that everything is correct. Thanks to your help with the variables, okay? Reload. Oh my God. My first block, everything is equal here in the editor, okay? Okay, that in the response is not available in JSON. Okay. Okay, internal error. We have an error here. Attributes.
You're missing as file props. The function is get block for attribute as. You're missing as.
In the.
No, in the same file you worked over there.
Here?
Just go down file props. The function.
Get block.
You're missing S there. Yes, there. So at
the end,
before
the end.
Attributes.
Ah, okay. Oh my God. The S, sorry. Okay. Get block wrapper attributes. Okay. Okay. A typical one letter error. Okay. We are going to try to update this. Okay, oh my God, for a letter. Typical errors, thank you. Oh my God, for a only letter. Okay, you know that this kind of errors. Okay, hello, welcome Europe. And like this is PHP, we can now echo more information, okay? I don't know. If you want to put more information like hello world, okay?
And there is a, we can put that.
And you will get the information.
Can we put this in the backend as well?
What?
Can we put this in the editor as well?
Yes, I can put it. But this is the a new way to introduce information only in the front-end side, but not in the editor side. Okay, I can put this test in the edit.js, but I don't have to do it. Okay, if we had this information with the save.js, we would have to have the same information in both of the files. Okay. Do you want something? Ah, no, ah, okay, just scratching, okay. Okay, save.js, edit.js, render.php, okay. So we have only 10 minutes, okay. I will try to introduce you to the, I have to the block controls and custom fields, but I think that, well, I will introduce fastly the custom fields, okay? Which have followed all the code, we will be able to do it, okay? We have to go to the, I will close this. We have to go to the my first block PHP, and we will set a custom field, okay? We will connect a custom field to the API. Because the render will need we will need that custom field accessible for the API, okay? So we have to. Okay, this function, okay. Function init register post meta, okay? We are going to register a post meta for that block, okay? Add action in the init. I will do it fastly in 10 minutes just for explain this because it's very useful, okay? And the function register for post meta, okay? For pages, we have to set here page because we are writing the blog in a page. So if we write here a post, we will be able to use that custom field only in post. Okay, so we have to write page, and the name of the value will be for example other description. Okay, other description. Okay, and we have to use now an array set show in res arrow true to see to WordPress that we need that attribute in that attribute, okay, that custom field show it in the res, okay, in the API res. Single the type of the attribute, okay, that will be a string, and the we don't have to use it, but it's useful if you want to upload your plugin to the repository of WordPress. You will need to sanitize the custom fields, okay? So we will use the sanities callback param to put the function, the typical function to sanitize to escape text input, okay? That is double p cases post, okay? Okay, with this code, today I will upload everything of this code in a GitHub, and you will be able to see the code and copy and test it, okay? And I will show and I will upload to more examples of more blocks that I have in testing environments, okay? So you will be able to learn a little bit more of the workshop, okay? So register post meta, okay. We need now to go to the edit and insert now a new import that is use use entity prop, okay? Use entity prop from work from WordPress core data, okay? WordPress/core data. With this function, we will be able to use custom field. Okay? We have to insert this here. This import, okay? Now we have to set here the contents. The contents, and after the curly brackets, we have to put this code, okay? To get access to that custom field, okay? So cons bracket meta update meta equal to use entity prop, and we have to give some params here. Post type equal to page, and meta, the name of the meta will be the meta will be context ID, okay? It's like the post ID. With the context, with this variable, we will be able to access to the post type of the block, of the post that is using that block, okay, if context, okay, if we are using this block in a page, context, we will give us here context, the context we will give us in the post type that is using this block, and here the post ID, okay, of the post, okay. Meta, and on the chain, we are going, for example, to copy and paste one text control. We have to chain only one thing, or we can chain to the label, okay? Other description. And we have to chain this, okay? We have to use the update meta, okay? That will be the name of the custom field that was other description, okay? Other description. Not with parentheses. Okay, and now update meta, parentheses, brackets, .. meta, comma, and we have to set other description with the value from here, okay? Okay, yes, okay, thank you. Oh my God. Okay, we have now the update meta here. The meta, okay. And we will be able now to go to the render PHP, use here the global post, that this variable will give us the information of the post. Oh my God, sorry. This variable will give us the information about the block, about the post that is using our block, okay? So we can go here and get a typical get post meta. For example, other, I will call copy, okay? Other description. Other description is equal to get post meta post ID. Other description, and to get the value as a single string, we have to use the true. So we will be able to get from this, by this way, the order description. Only 1 minute. Open PHP, close, echo, order description. If we don't have fails here, okay, everything is well. We can remove the block, save, reload. My first block. Okay, I forgot the panel row. The panel row here. Okay, reload, load. My first block, and we will have here now the custom field. For example, other description. Okay, well, there is an error here with the custom field. So for going so fast, up to the top, okay. Okay, sorry. Yes, I will put the code in GitHub, okay? I didn't change the value, okay? Was attribute, so we have to access to meta, and there we have it's like an attribute, but for the attribute with custom fields, okay? So, fastly change again all.
Many learn in 2 hours.
Yes, I have more information. Okay. So will it be impossible to to use this? Okay. So I hope that you have learned something about creating Gutenberg blocks. Okay. I have tried to show how to use custom fields, but okay, we didn't have enough time for this. But at least you know how to create blocks from scratch. You know too to create to render the block as a PHP, and well, that's all. I think that the mission more or less has been accomplished. No? Well, thank you to you. Have a nice WordCamp, and thanks to the organization.